Good morning, MHS. I'm Nick Orchanian.
And I'm Millie Bone.
And this is MHS Info. Summer is almost here. Finals will end the year. And all the students will cheer.
Good luck, MHS. Nick, take it with the news.
In MHS sports news, congrats to Connor Aylett and Charlie Levinson, who made it to the state finals for boys tennis. The doubles team is looking ahead to next year to reclaim their state title.
In other sports news, congrats to boys lacrosse for a great season after losing in the state semifinal game this past Wednesday. This is the farthest the boys lacrosse team has ever gone. Congrats again on a great season. In other news, some of you may know that June is Pride Month. Today at lunch, the MHS GSA's second annual flag scavenger hunt will take place. Find LGBT flags hidden around the school and bring them to the overpass by Carol Scheffler's office. You can win baked goods and enter your name in a raffle for a $10 Starbucks gift card. Each student can turn in a maximum of 2 flags. The hunt is a great way to win prizes and, most importantly, show support for your LGBTQ classmates. And now for a quick promo about an exciting musical event happening in the future at MHS.
This year, for the first time, Pace is hosting a very special event titled Pace, Love, and Music. It will take place at Garcia's at the Capitol Theater on Monday, June 17th at 7 p.m. and feature 13 student composers. Please come out and support these artists and hear some incredible live music. Tickets are $10 and the event is likely to sell out. You can buy tickets at the door, but you are encouraged to buy them at Ticketfly.com.
And now for our featured news story of the day. With seniors on internship and AP tests over, there is some confusion about where juniors can park their cars. Here with the story on the issue are info field reporters Cameron Thede, Jacob Ross, Sara, Nidus, and Morgan Robinson. Let's take a look.
With APs over and internships in full swing, Mamaroneck High School is looking emptier than ever. However, this was not the case a week ago. Every year during AP week, there seems to be a reoccurring problem that many seek to address, the highly debated topic of juniors being allowed to park in senior lot. Today, we will search the school and hear from many who have different perspectives on the topic.
I think if juniors can park in slot as long as there are enough spots for seniors, I think it's fine.
During this two-week period, most seniors are not attending classes. However, many have AP tests that they have to come in for. These seniors have been finding that their once sacred parking lot is now being overrun by the juniors.
This is Cameron Thede reporting in at Senior Lot, and we spotted several juniors' cars, including Quinn Reavy, Will Popley, and several others. It's becoming an epidemic out here.
Student Council recently posted a warning urging juniors not to park in Senior Lot. However, the message seems to have been ignored.
I don't think people are going to listen to what Student Council said.
We interviewed the man who posted it himself, Junior Eli Gottsagen.
I don't think people are going to listen to me very much. I think that people will do whatever they want.
We also went to the parking expert to get an opinion on the situation.
Oh, this is a testy conversation right now. It's tough. There's not enough parking for anyone. But our juniors need to understand it. Parking is kind of like a rite of passage. Half of our seniors are gone. They're on internship. The other half are taking APs.
When asked about the rule breaking, Ms. Klein had a clear opinion.
They can't park in senior lot.
But the question is, where else can they park?
Yeah, don't park illegally. That's not my opinion, it's the law.
Due to the lack of an official rule being placed on juniors by any school supervisor, it seems that this issue remains as a mere feud between juniors and seniors. So far, juniors appear to be getting their way.
Millie, I have to go move my car.
And that was MHS Info.